Hello, this is Zixiao Yang, and this is my lab report for Lab 1 in Physics 2212 class. And this lab report will consist of these three main parts: introduction, data and observation, and calculation and glow script. For the introduction part, the concept we used in this lab includes Newton's second law, which is F equal to ma, the force on an object is equal to the mass of it times the acceleration of it. Newton's third law, which says every force has a reaction force with same magnitude and opposite direction. And the Coulomb's law, F is equal to KQ1 Q2 divided by R squared. Sorry, this is a typo error. And which it says the force on an object is equal to Coulomb's constant times object 1's charge times object 2's charge divided by the distance between them squared. And this lab, we use clear tapes to estimate the charge between tapes and between tapes and hand. So the data in this lab, the tape we used has a length of 15 centimeters and a width of 1 centimeter, which is 0.15 meter and 0.01 meter in the calculation. And the tape mass is approximately 0.1 gram, and we will use 0.0001 kilogram in the calculation. The result here, the attraction between tape and hand is very obvious. The repulsion between two tapes is not very obvious. And I will talk about that at the end. And in the calculation part, we assume that there is no air resistance, and we treat tape as one point to calculate the force. And we assume that the charges are evenly distributed on the tape. And here is my code in calculation and the diagram it gives me from glow script. So we have the Coulomb's constant as 9 times 10 to the 9th. Our Q as the constant for the charge is 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19, and our gravity constant as negative 9.8 because it's pointing downward. We have the mass of tape, M tape equal to 0.0001, the length of the tape, L tape equal to 0.15, and the width of the tape, W tape equal to 0.01. The distance here is the distance I believe there is some repulsion between the tapes when they are very close to each other in my case. So it's about 0.005 meter, which is about 0.5 centimeters. And the length of the atom we use here is 1 times 10 to the negative 10th meters. First, we have the gravity calculated as M tape times the gravity constant, and then the F is equal to the absolute value of gravity, so it can balance the force to have the upper tape stay. And in the calculation for our charge, we calculate the distance first, which is the R is equal to the observation location minus the particle. So it's D on the y-axis, and we have R magnitude. R mag is equal to magnitude of R. R hat is equal to R divided by R mag, which is the unit vector. Q here, we use square root of F times R mag squared divided by the Coulomb's constant, because we know that F is equal to KQ1 Q2 divided by R squared, and here we have the Q1 Q2 is both equal to Q, so it is Q is equal to square root of F times R squared divided by K. And when we print that out, and the number of charges, we have Q divided by big Q. So we print that out as well. And to show them, we use T1 and T2 so that we can see it on our diagram. The reason I use the position vector as 0, negative d, divided by 3, and 0 for t2. It's because I want to make the two close to each other on the diagram to see them clear. And the arrow pointing downward is gravity, pointing upward is the force. And we use the width of the tape times the length of the tape divided by the length of atom square to have the number of atoms on the tape, and then we use that to divide it by number of charges. We calculated before to get the ratio, and the final answers are here. We have the charge on the tape, it's about 1.6 times 10 to the 9th, and we have the number of charges on the tape, it's about 1.03 times 10 to the 10th, and the ratio of excess electrons is about 1 to 1.45 times 10 to the 7th. For the questions, what if the electrons had positive charge and protons had negative charge? It's simply we flip the two charges. I believe there's no changes because you have a positive charge attract to a negative charge, and now it's a negative charge attract to a positive charge. And you, when you have same charges, they still have a repulsion force, so it's the same. And why is it important to handle the charge tape as little as possible? I believe the reason is the electron will be transferred to objects that get into contact with the tape. So in my experiment, I believe that's why I did not see very visible observation in my experiment. Maybe the tape lost a great amount of electrons before I used them to get in touch with each other. And that's all for this lab. Thanks for watching.